Good morning and thank you for coming to our second meeting regarding the operation of our company. The purpose of this meeting are to improve our company by laying off employees and improving our product. Before we start our meeting, would you like to take down the meeting, Ms. EJ?
Sure, no problem. Sorry, everybody, I'm late.
Has anyone read the agenda before the meeting start?
Yes.
Is there any apology for absent?
Yes, Ms. Robinson is currently away for a business conference in Australia. She will be back in the first flight tomorrow.
Okay, thank you. Can we proceed to the minute of our previous meeting now?
Yes.
Please read the minute of the last meeting which were distributed earlier. Are there any amendments?
Yes, Ms. Chan, there's a correction to item 3.1. The malfunctioning of machine occurred frequently at factory 9 instead of factory 13.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Han. I'll make the necessary correction. For the item 3.2, the injury incident rates, can I invite Ms. Chan to present us the injury incident rates of the half of the year 2016?
Yes, for sure. After conducting the investigation and gathering all the information, the incident rate of the first half of the year 2016 was 3.6%.
Okay, not that with that.
Is there any other amendment?
No.
Thank you. Can someone propose the minute to be passed as the true record?
I propose the minute to be accepted. I second the motion.
Okay, let's move on to our main issue today. Currently, there is a decline in the economy growth and our company is facing a financial crisis. After discussing with top management, we may undergo layoff to reduce overhead costs to improve our product in order to increase the image of our company. However, layoff is not a perfect way to end. Top management would like to correct all of your opinion. So, do you agree to proceed the laying off strategy? Please clarify your stand with your reason.
I propose to reject the laying off plan. In my opinion, R&D is the core department of our company. Knowledge and experience would be an advantage to my department. Hence, my department will optimize experts and professionals as much as possible.
Yes, I agree with Ms. Han Yun. Manpower is important to my department. Manpower is required to operate various types of machine, check out products manually for improvement, and troubleshoot with arising problems to ensure continuous and smooth operation.
I agree on the laying off plan. Regarding the number of employees of my department, only a few officials who possess the relevant experience and skill which are required by my department. So I think that it is enough as the department mostly relying on the machine for effective quality control.
I do entirely agree with the opinion of Ms. Shilei. If the workers need to complete several tasks in a certain period, the worker will certainly get tired and difficult to concentrate on other tasks. It is severe as this will influence the daily operation and this might cause an unnecessary accident.
Sorry to interrupt, Ms. Lepoy.
Yes.
To be honest, it can be solved by proper time and manpower management. For example, managing my time isn't about squeezing as many tasks in a day as possible. It is about simplifying how I'm doing the work and how I'm relieving the stress.
I do not see eye to eye with Ms. Shilin. As the world's largest rubber glove manufacturer, our research team consists of a number of people working together in a committed way towards a common research goal. Multitasking for an employee might work. However, we cannot deny the fact that it is a poor approach to productivity.
Yes, I think it is wrong. Let's move on.
Okay, but
excuse me, Ms. Pupu and Ms. Shilin. Can all of you pay attention to Ms. Tanrin? This is an important part of the operation of our company. I don't want any of you to miss it. Understand?
Sorry, Ms. Chan. We will not repeat the same mistake again.
Thank you for your cooperation. Ms. Ije, do you have any opinions?
Well, laying off employees is a very cost-effective option. However, there is no sense of belonging to the employees with the company. This will create a sense of distrust from employees toward top management. The employees who have been retained may seek employment in other companies as soon as possible.
Since all of you disagree or for this plan, I will follow the majority.
Alright, after listening to all of the opinions, the final decision is to reject the layoff plan. So, are there any suggestions for the alternative of the layoff employee plans?
Yes, Ms. Chan. We can offer extra days of unpaid leave and extend time off to the employees. Instead of offering 2 weeks of vacation with pay, we can offer 4 weeks, 2 of which are paid.
For me, cutting other costs will be a strategy to avoid employee layoffs. We can freeze additional hiring and cut bonuses, raises, unnecessary travel and overtime of the employees.
We can also reduce the working hours or work week of employees, for example, reducing the number of hours employees work and proportionally decrease pay. This can be a seasonal arrangement for slow periods.
In my opinion, to avoid employee layoff, lay all contract and part-time staff go. It's legally easier and cheaper to end their employment or rehire retired employees that already know our business practice as necessary.
Thank you for the suggestion. I will pass your opinions to the top management. Is there any other suggestion?
No.
If there is nothing else, let's move on to our next issue regarding the quality improvement of the product. As our motto states, top quality,
top efficiency.
Anyone has any suggestion to further increase the quality of our product since we received many complaints recently?
In my viewpoint, the most crucial way to increase the quality of our product is to develop performance measurement. Identify problem, predict outcomes, and measure productivity using the key performance indicators of our company, such as profit, cost, and also the sales by region.
I think that we can conduct R&D, which can lead to innovations to increase the quality of the products. This may in terms of new products and improved processes, which can result in greater profits and lower costs.
Yes, it sounds great. We can also analyze the process and to increase the quality of the product. By focusing on the tasks, we can standardize policy and procedures for each of the products to maximize their efficiency.
I suggest that building testing quality.
Sorry.
I suggest that building quality testing before, during, after process. By doing this, defective component problem can be solved. Once we encounter them, without waiting for the entire testing cycle to complete.
Well, we can conduct extensive market research to identify the needs and desires of customers. We can use the feedback from customers, suppliers, and business partners to improve and develop new products. For example, conduct surveys to gather information to improve current products and prepare a report summarized findings.
Moreover, we can align business process with other companies in the same industry. I still remember the American Productivity and Quality Center website provides tools including the process classification framework. we may take a look and refer it to improve the quality of our products.
After listening to the suggestion by Ms. Puipui, I think that we can use the business strategy such as Six Sigma to improve quality. We can determine the root cause of the issue and design interventions to improve the process so that defects get correct earlier before they impact our final product.
Sorry, I'm in a daze. Please stay focused on our meeting.
Well, there is one more add-on which is providing training to our employees. We can train all personnel adequately so that they can produce a high-quality product. We should also provide in-house industrial training to sharpen and keeping their skills and knowledge up to date through this cost-effective method.
Alright, that's all. Anything else to add on?
No.
Okay then, if there's nothing, let us design the date of our next meeting.
What about 12 January 2017 at 10 AM in executive meeting room? If all agree with this time and venue, I will send a notice to all members a week before the day.
Okay.
Thank you all. Before we end our meeting, let me summarize the main point in this meeting. The first one, we have agreed on the alternative on the laying of plan. The second one, we have agreed on the way to improve the quality of our product. I will pass all this opinion to the top management. Right, it looks like we have covered everything. I would like to thank everyone for coming to our meeting today. See you all at the next meeting, which is on 12 January 2017. Will someone propose the meeting be adjourned?
Yes, I propose the meeting to be adjourned.
Seconder?
I second the motion.
Thank you. The meeting is adjourned. Has a nice day.
Thank you.